Rejected and despised. Christ is here in contrast with the rich, the learned, the religious and the irreligious of our day, Christendom. The Holy Spirit gives the spirit of a sound mind. To sacrifice present interests for eternal ones is wise. Is it any wonder that artists represent the world as wealth mad, glory mad, pleasure mad? The Christian Herald of a somewhat similar picture says, this allegory, which a critic has aptly called a painter's sermon, is applicable to conditions in every part of the civilized world. It is a picture to study and to ponder over that the full import of its teachings may be understood. The Christian Commonwealth of the same says, on either side passes the heedless crowd. A prominent figure is a priest, proudly conscious of the perfection of the ritual with which he is starving a higher life. Over the shoulder of the priest looks a stern-faced divine, a very different type, and, Bible in hand, he turns to look at the divine figure. The startled look on the face of a hospital nurse in the foreground is very realistic. So absorbed is the man of science with his test tube that he never glances at the Christ at his side. One of the most striking features is that of a false beauty, hurrying from one scene of pleasure to another. In the background stands an angel with bowed head, holding the cup which the world he loved to the death is still compelling the Christ to drink. The passers-by represent the non-elect, whose only hope lies in the kingdom of Messiah. The elect in this picture are represented in the person of the suffering Savior, members of the body of Christ, the Church. He that despiseth you despiseth me. These faithful members of the body of Christ are not confined to one denomination, but constitute the saintly ones of every church and outside of every human system. They are the wise virgin class, being fitted by ignominy for the heavenly kingdom and its great work of blessing humanity, the non-elect.